My name is Richard Woods, and again, I can honestly say I am not in South Georgia. This is a beautiful part of the state, but I do live in Tifton, Georgia. So I'm about four and a half miles south of here. But it is a privilege to be the Republican nominee for State Superintendent of Schools. And as your next state school superintendent, again, one of the things I can assure you is that I do bring experience to this office. Again, for 22 years, I worked in the Irwin County school system, working 14 years as a classroom social studies teacher and 8 years in administration, working from assistant principal, principal, K-5 curriculum director, and the list goes on and on with that. But again, everything was pre-K through 12th grade at the school level. So, things that I talk about come from firsthand experience. And because of I have that firsthand experience, one of the things we look at is that what are we going to do for our children, and what are we going to do for our school system to make sure that each child has the opportunity to succeed? Well, first thing, we are going to be child-focused, and that means we are going to make sure that we personalize and not standardize education, because our children, it is not one size fits all. They are completely different, and we need to have the flexibility to take our children where they are at and move them forward. And that is my commitment to do that, because if we fail the children, honestly, we have failed in education. So that will be the primary focus to do that. But in order to make sure that we are personalize our education system, that means we've got to go to our teachers. And we've got to allow our teachers to once again do the job that they went to school to do. And we do that by reducing and eliminating unnecessary paperwork, data collecting. And instead of teaching to the test, we teach to the child. Again, coming from a period with No Child Left Behind, which I worked very diligently with, all we heard about was the test, the test, the test. Well, at that point, we began to miss the important thing in education, where it should be about the child, the child, the child. And in doing that, by focusing on our teachers and our kids, that means we concentrate on our classroom. By concentrating on the classroom, we will make sure that our kids, by the time they leave fifth grade, they will be proficient in reading, writing, and math, because those are the foundational skills that build on everything else that goes on beyond that point. For myself as a high school social studies teacher, content was not an issue. But the issue that I had was that we knew our kids needed to read and reading comprehension. And as your next state school superintendent, my commitment is to make Georgia the number one literate state in our nation. Because if we can teach our kids to read, if they can have that foundation, the doors of opportunity will be boundless to them. And so we will do that. But also being a foundationist, that means that we'll do some things that we look at and we make sure that our kids understand and appreciate our great, rich history. We will teach history and be more diligent with that. We will teach the Constitution, the Declaration of Independence, the Federalist Papers, all the great works that we have. We will not leave that out, because I firmly believe that as our children leave high school and Georgia education, if they understand it's better to be independent from and not dependent on government, we have done a great thing. Because that means we will have citizens that will begin to build on our capitalistic, system we have as far as economics, but also they will remember and cherish, what has made America great. And that is something that we have to do that is very, very important. Again, I also need your help. And again, please go to my website, woodsforsuper.com, and visit there, but join us on Facebook and Twitter, because I still do math the old-fashioned way. And what I understand is that I'm just one individual, but you out here, you know 10 people who know 10 people who know 10 people. And so we have to get that message out that we have the best plan and we have the best organization for us. And now I would like to introduce our current and our next Commissioner of Labor, or Secretary of Labor, Mark Butler. So again, appreciate that.